Hello, it's Warren. Tell us a little bit about operational models and what do you do as a consultant and how does that apply to startups as today here in the training program?
Right, so specifically to operating models, it's a way of representing how you want the company to work. The big companies have been using this for some time now to generate more efficiencies predominantly. So they think about how they're doing their work, finding new ways to improve it. And from there, you can design how the company should be structured and where you need people and what are the jobs that need doing. Now, this is an area that startups haven't really been doing so much of. Business models are sexy. People like doing that. They like to know how they're going to make their millions and become the next Google or the next Facebook and become the next internet billionaire. That's sexy. They love it. It's fantastic. But the key to that is to go through this rapid growth, you need to know how you want to structure your business in almost a physical sense, although it's not physical, it's about your company, how you want work to flow through of it. Startups famously hate process. They like to be quick, they like to be responsive. But after a certain size, when your close-knit group share the same beliefs on standards and you have more people coming in, how do you communicate these standards? You want your customers to have the same, if not better, experience every single time consistently. You need to articulate this in process and have a way to communicate it to the wider people. So why is it important to startups? A lot of the startups here today, they're going to get funding. They're going to get a big check from their investors to make their ideas and their strategies come alive. If they don't plan how they want to do it, firstly, they could hire the people in the wrong place because they've not calculated exactly all the jobs in the full picture that they need doing. Like how many salespeople they need versus how many developers do they need versus how many customer support people do you need? Where are the jobs going to be? Where are the likely demands going to be? How's work going to be done? Is it being done in the most efficient fashion? You're going from a team to a company to an even bigger company with branches in different countries. So what it is so that you don't hire from 20 to 60 people and you've realized that 40 people are doing the wrong jobs or it's the wrong type of skills they need. It's just that pre-planning that will prevent all these mistakes and give you the best chance of realizing your goals.
So it's about where people are located in your company, but is it also about when to hire people? Because sometimes when you get a big bag full of big money, you want to hire everyone and do everything in the same time, because at startups it's about rhythm. So what about that?
Yes, exactly. So it's also about where do you need these jobs, but what are the people going to do, and a timeline to it. So an operating model, when you come up with your intent, it's often called the target operating model because it's a target. That's what you're working towards. So when you get your big fat check and you're developing a brilliant technology, it might be tempting to hire as many of the most expensive developers now, but you could be shooting yourself in the foot because you don't have the money to then hire the salespeople to sell it, to monetize it. So it's all about that planning. It's estimating, actually this needs to be built in that period in the development cycle so I can afford this many people, versus I have now allocated enough money to get my salespeople on the ground. When are they going to start being hired so that when the product is ready to be released, the market knows about it, they're starting to know about it. The salespeople will need time to understand the product, to sell it properly. So it just gives you a big picture to know what are the jobs you need doing, what specifically how are they going to work in the company, when do you need them, and how many in which bits do you need, so that you don't make the mistake right up front.
Do you find it easier to work with big companies or with startups to do this type of job?
It's easier with startups. It's more exciting. Firstly, now, I'm from London, and in London, startups are now cool. Big companies want to be like startups. A lot of big companies tell me the biggest risk to us is a startup app developer makes an app in a week. My company takes 3 months to make the same app. It's a big risk to them. They want to be like the startups. Whether it's easy or difficult, I mean, they're different types of challenges, but fundamentally, it's the same thing. So for a startup looking how they want to work, they need to consider it in just as much detail. If they're expanding internationally, it's the same types of consideration a big company would do. Yes, they don't have as much money, they don't have as many people, but that actually means getting it wrong becomes even more expensive, because a big company has a cash pile. They can go, right, we made a mistake, let's try again. Versus for you, your investor will just say, no thank you, no more money for you, I'm going to go find someone else. So it's a different challenge. I don't think one's harder than the other, but you know, startups need to do this, and it's an exciting time for all of them. Thank you.